Welcome back to the lab. Today, we continue purifying reagents to eventually make some phosphorescent materials. If you look at my first attempt at making a silver-doped blue phosphor, it was very dim. The main problem was the purity of my silver nitrate, and this is what we are going to fix today. Silver has the uncommon property that its chloride is insoluble in water, and this is the property we are going to use to separate it from impurities. The plan is as follows. We are starting with silver nitrate and we'll use potassium chloride to precipitate silver chloride. Then we'll use potassium hydroxide to form silver oxide, which we'll need to reduce to silver metal powder. There are many reducing agents that will work. Formaldehyde is known to work, some reducing sugars are known to work as well. However, I happen to have some vitamin C lying around, which should behave as a reducing agent. So, instead of following a known path, today we'll formulate a little research question. Can ascorbic acid reduce silver oxide to silver metal? And try this hypothesis with an experiment. Let's begin with the first step of the reaction. First, let's dissolve the silver nitrate in water. I pre-weighed it, and we are working with 4.7 grams. While the silver nitrate is dissolving, we can prepare the potassium chloride solution. We could have used sodium chloride just as well, but I happen to have analytical grade potassium chloride which won't introduce more unwanted impurities. For 4.7 grams of silver nitrate, we are going to use 3 grams of potassium chloride, which is a 45% excess, to make sure all silver precipitates as the chloride. Looks like we have our first problem. The silver nitrate does not bond to fully dissolve. As we want a clear solution with no undissolved material, it's time for an unplanned filtration. Finally, it's time to precipitate the silver chloride. The precipitate needs to be decanted and washed with fresh deionized water several times. This is the step when we remove the impurities. Now that we have our silver chloride, it's time to prepare a potassium hydroxide solution to form the silver oxide. For this amount of silver, we'll use 3 grams of potassium hydroxide, which is 2 times excess. Also in this case, I'm using potassium hydroxide because the one I have is more pure than my sodium hydroxide, which is drain cleaner grade. At first, I stirred for 1 hour without heating, but the reaction seemed to progress too slowly, as I could see some white flakes of silver chloride. So I decanted some of the water to reduce the volume, added 3 more grams of hydroxide, and this time heated the beaker to 60 degrees. After a couple of hours, the reaction looked complete. Now, it's time to try reducing the silver oxide to silver metal with vitamin C. I used 6 grams, a 20% excess, which was added directly to the previous reaction mixture, without removing the residual hydroxide. Initially, the reaction mixture turned green and heated up. I heated the beaker to 80 degrees and stirred for 2 hours, after which the solution turned yellow-orange and I could see the silver powder which clumped together at the bottom of the beaker. The liquid was decanted and washed with deionized water several times. At this point, I have pure silver metal powder, But to make the phosphorescent materials, I need to convert it back to silver nitrate by adding nitric acid. This is the most dangerous part of the process, as the reaction liberates nitrogen dioxide, which is a toxic gas. Although the scale of this reaction was quite small, my fume hood wasn't complete at the time when I made this experiment, so instead of performing the reaction in a beaker, I assembled this closed apparatus with a sucker trap and sodium hydroxide scrubber to absorb the nitrogen dioxide. Here's why you need the suck back trap. As the reaction starts, the volume of air in the apparatus shrinks, and without the suck back trap, the sodium hydroxide would drip into the reaction flask, ruining the reaction. Be careful towards the end of the reaction, as the reaction flask looked clear as if it contained air, but that was nitrogen monoxide, a colorless gas that reacts with oxygen to form nitrogen dioxide. At the end of the reaction, there was still some unreacted solid, which could be silver oxide that was not reduced by the ascorbic acid, so it's time for another filtration. At this point, the silver nitrate was transferred to a beaker and put on a hot plate to evaporate the water. Don't set the hot plate temperature too high, silver nitrate is a salt that melts at a low temperature.